Very good. A very, very elegant touch, these violets, to my very, very, very valuable table. It should be a most enjoyable evening, having Mr. B, Mr. P, and Mr. Z dine with me. Let me see. I want everything to be perfect. I venture to say that my choice of victuals is most appropriate. We shall feast on foods that start with the same sound that starts violet velvet vest. A salad with vinegar and oil dressing, followed by veal, venison, and vegetables. And for dessert, vanilla ice cream. Ah, such vision! But I think I shall sample just a bit. Ah, very scrumptious. 6 o'clock. My guests will be arriving soon. I believe some music is in order. Ah, the sweet sobbing sounds of a violin. My very favorite music. Because violin starts with the same sound that starts violet velvet vest. Ah, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. My very, very, very favorite violet velvet vest. I wear it every day. They're here. Come in. Usually Vaughn, my valet, answers the door, but he's on vacation.
Am I late? Am I late, Mr. V? Boy, oh boy, I thought I'd never get out of that barber shop.
You're on time. But where are the others, Mr. P and Mr. Z?
They'll be here just as soon as they finish bouncing my basketball. Boy, oh boy, look at that food. I hope you're serving bread and butter, Mr. V. I love bread and butter because they start with the same sound that starts beautiful buttons.
No, Mr. B. Tonight we dine only on foods that start with my sound, violet velvet vest.
Speaking of your violet velvet vest, Mr. V.
Oh, were we?
It's a beautiful vest, but it's kind of plain.
It's my very favorite vest. I wear no other.
But, dear Mr. V, it is easy to see your vest needs a bit of help from me. A velvet vest without buttons won't do. So I'll give some beautiful buttons to you. My beautiful buttons, you will find, make your velvet vest the best of its kind. Come on, Mr. V, let's put some beautiful buttons on that violet velvet vest of yours.
But I like my vest just the way it is. I don't want any beautiful buttons on it.
Oh, but you do, you do. Yes, you really do. You'll see how very, very grand it looks with beautiful buttons.
I hope Mr. V's got a passel of pickles. Pickles are perfect.
I'd rather have zucchini. Zucchini is zippy.
Now, doesn't that look better?
Not really.
Howdy, partners. What's going on?
I've made Mr. V's vest look better. Just look at all those beautiful buttons.
I liked my violet velvet vest the way it was.
Well, that's a mighty pretty pattern, all right, Mr. B. But if you'll pardon me, I've got just the thing to make that violet velvet vest really perfect. Some pointy patches.
But I don't want any pointy patches, Mr. P.
Dear Mr. V, it is easy to see. Your vest needs a bit of help from me. A velvet vest without pointy patches won't do, so I'll give some pointy patches to you. Pointy patches, you will find, make your velvet vest the best of its kind. There you are, partner. Pointy patches. Now your vest is really perfect.
It was perfect without pointy patches and beautiful buttons.
Something isn't quite right. There's something missing from your violet velvet vest. Zowie, I've got it.
Oh, no.
Dear Mr. V, it is easy to see. Your vest needs a bit of help from me. A velvet vest without zipping zippers won't do. So I'll give some zipping zippers to you. Zipping zippers you will find make your velvet vest the best of its kind. By zingo, those zippers sure add zest to your vest, Mr. V. Go take a look in the mirror.
Oh, no. This will never do. Gentlemen, I appreciate your efforts, but my violet velvet vest looked very grand without your beautiful buttons, pointy patches, and zipping zippers. I don't need them. Would you please remove them from my very favorite violet velvet vest?
Very well, if that's what you want.
It's what I want. Easy there. Be careful. This is my very favorite violet velvet vest. You might tear it. Oh, no. Stop. Wait.
Oh, this is bad. Bad, bad, bad.
Ruined. My very favorite violet velvet vest is ruined. This is terrible. Terrible. I'm supposed to be on the catching game tomorrow. But I can't go looking like this. I can't go on television with a torn vest. I don't want anybody to see it. Never, ever. What am I going to do?
We could put back our beautiful buttons, pointy patches, and zipping zippers.
Or you could wear another vest.
No, 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 that won't do. This is my very favorite vest, my best. I wear it every day. Look how you've ruined the left side of my vest. That makes me angry.
We're really sorry, Mr. V.
We didn't mean to tear your vest.
It was an accident.
Ah, very well. I accept your apologies, but what am I going to do about my torn vest? I can't have anyone looking at the torn side of my vest.
But Mr. V, you have to be on the catching game. We need you to help us make words.
I will not be on the catching game. I will not help you make words because I'm never, ever going to be in another word again. Then no one will ever see the torn side of my violet velvet vest.
Boy, oh boy, Mr. V, you can't do that. What's going to happen to all the words that start with the same sound that starts violet velvet vest?
Like violin and vegetables and vanilla. Oh, Mr. B, we wouldn't have that variety of words anymore, would we?
You'll have to think of something else, Mr. V.
I've got it. The only time anyone can see the left side of my vest is if I stand at the end of a word. And so, I will never end a word.
On your left side, like this, Mr. V?
Yes. See how you're hiding the rips in my vest.
Say, that's a pretty powerful idea, Mr. V, never ending a word.
And if you make your sound only at the start or in the middle of a word, somebody will always be there to hide the left side of your vest.
A bang-up idea, Mr. V, never ending a word. Now that you've settled that, let's eat.
Mr. B, how can you think of food at a time like this?
By golly, you're right, Mr. V. I'd sure like to give some beautiful buttons to someone else.
And I'd like to pin my pointy patches on someone else.
And I'd like to zip my zipping zippers on someone else. Who could it be?
I know. Boy, oh boy, I know. Mr. S. We'll stitch him on his super socks.
A zipping good idea, Mr. B.
That's plenty powerful, all right. Let's push off pronto.
Wait, what about your dinner? Such a shame to let these vitamin-packed vegetables go to waste. But then, I could use a little morsel myself. I'll try a little of this veal. And this venison. And these vegetables. And maybe it will take my mind off my torn violet velvet vest.
Hey, Kang, come here. I say it, I say it, I say it. Hey, small side. Gonna make a circle. We're going to make a circle. Huh? Come on, we're trying to make a circle. We'll try it your way later. Oh, all right. My way now? Can we do it my way? Come on, huh?
Man, oh man, this superhero business sure is hard on my super socks. Seems like I have to sew them up 6 or 7 times a day. Every time I slip out to save someone, my super socks somehow get torn. Like the time Silly Sally sees Sizzle's sister and slipped my socks with her scissors. She would have snipped all day, but thanks to me and my super socks, everything turned out swell.
Boy, oh boy, what are you doing, Mr. S?
Sewing up my super socks, but I finished. See, they're good as new. Aren't they sensational?
Yes. They're beautiful, all right. Beautiful, beautiful super socks. But we can make them better.
Make them better? Oh, no. My super socks are super just the way they are.
Pardon my preaching, Mr. S, but putting it practically, your super socks could use a few pointy patches, if you ask me.
And some zipping zippers.
And some beautiful, beautiful buttons.
Pointy patches, zipping zippers, beautiful buttons on my spiffy super socks. Stitching splotches on my super socks will spoil them. No, thank you, sirs. They're quite splendid now.
But dear Mr. S, it is easy to see. Your socks need a bit of help from me.
And me.
And me.
super socks without beautiful buttons.
And pointy patches.
And zipping zippers.
Just won't do. So I will give some beautiful buttons.
And pointy patches.
And zipping zippers to you.
Beautiful buttons.
Pointy patches.
And zipping zippers.
You will find, make your super socks the grandest kind. Just feast your peepers on that, Mr. S.
Where are my super socks? I can't see them anymore. They've slithered south. I want my super socks back.
You've still got your socks, partner, but now they're plastered with pointy patches, beautiful buttons, and zipping zippers.
Look, I don't want to be a spoil sport, but I don't want pointy patches, beautiful buttons, or zipping zippers. I want my super socks. Please take these swatches off.
Oh, all right.
Pulling these patches off sure makes me feel bad. But there you go, Mr. S. All my pointy patches are pulled.
And so are all my beautiful buttons. It's sort of sad.
You're struggling with your snipping, Mr. C. I don't need these zipping zippers.
Sowie, but you do, Mr. S. Look, if you wear just one zipping zipper on your super socks, I'll give you something you'll really like. How would you like to share my sound?
The same sound that starts zipping zippers?
Right. Whenever you wear a zipping zipper on your super socks, I'll let you share my sound.
You mean you're giving me your sound, Mr. Z?
Well, not quite. I'll let you use my sound sometimes, but when you do, you have to wear a zipping zipper on your super socks.
But I already have a sound. The same sound that starts super socks.
But now you'll have two. Your sound and my sound. Sometimes. Here's how it will work. Just a minute. Will you two go and get Mr. H and Ms. I? That way I'll show Mr. S how I'll share my sound with him.
On our way, pal. Come on, B, old buddy. Let's push off.
Now, Mr. S, as I was saying, I'll let you share my sound, but only sometimes. And only in the middle or at the end of a word. Never at the beginning of a word. Only I can make my Z sound at the beginning of a word. How does that sound?
Sounds super, Mr. Z. Okay, I agree. I'll wear a zipping zipper on my super socks sometimes. And when I do, I may use your Z sound. Who knows? It may come in handy someday. Me being a superhero, you know.
Mr. H, Ms. I, just in time to help me show Mr. S how he's going to share my sound.
Two sounds. That's incredible, Mr. Z.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to make a word that will let Mr. S use my Z sound. Ms. I, whose socks are those?
Those are Mr. S's super socks. They're his socks.
Right. His socks. And that's the word we're going to make. We'll use those sock boxes over there for clue boxes. Mr. H, if you get in the starting clue box, Ms. I, you get in the catching clue box, and Mr. S, you get in the ending clue box. Now, let's quickly review sounds. Mr. H gets his sound from the same sound that starts horrible hair.
And I get my sound from the same sound that starts itchy itch.
And I get my sound from the same sound that starts super socks.
That's true, Mr. S, but remember our agreement. Right now, you're wearing my zipping zippers.
And I'm at the end of a word, so that means I get to use Mr. Z's Z sound.
That's right. As long as you're in the middle or at the end of a word and wearing zipping zippers on your super socks, you can use my sound. All right, letter people, let's try it. Make your sounds catch.
His.
Try it again.
His.
Wow! I used your sound, Mr. Z. I'm really a superhero now. Two sounds.
Well, it's sort of zingy, all right. But remember, Mr. S, you can only use my sound sometimes, but never at the beginning of a word.
I'll remember. Only in the middle or at the end of a word, and only when I'm wearing a zipping zipper on my super socks. I won't forget, Mr. Z. Thanks a lot. Now I'll stuff these zipping zippers in my secret satchel for safekeeping.
This calls for a celebration. Let's all go down to my itsy witsy ice cream club. And I'll treat all of you to a tall, cool, frosty ice cream soda. Thank you.
3. 1, 2, 3.
Catching game. Aren't you finished down there yet, Mr. H?
Yeah. All done. Push the button, swell. Let's see if this thing works.
All righty. Here's one for Mother.
Huh?
My clothes. The man from Flat never gets into this kind of trouble.
Oh. Hey, swell. I think you got your wires crossed.
That's the pressure of the business. Oh, yeah. Mother, gooey mess.
Beg your pardon, Mr. Swell, but... what is that strange odor I smell?
It's air freshener. Essence of steamed asparagus. Oh, Mr. V. You're a bit early, aren't you? I mean, it isn't even time for my warm-up yet.
I'm here early, Mr. Swell, because I have something very important to discuss with you.
Where'd you get that vest, Mr. V? Garage sale? Let your dog play with it? I know, you ran over it with your lawnmower.
This is no joking matter, sir. Oh. My torn vest is precisely the reason I am here.
Sorry, Mr. B, but we don't sell used clothes on the catching game.
Oh, I wouldn't dream of selling my very favorite violet velvet vest, no matter how torn it is.
Yeah? Well, if you want to buy a new vest, Mr. V, I'll loan you a couple bucks to payday. I mean, you can't go on my show looking like that.
Exactly. And that's why I've decided to never, ever end a word. I'll only be at the start or in the middle of a word. That way a letter person will always be on my left side, hiding the torn part of my violet velvet vest.
Now, just a minute, Mr. V. I am the star of this show. Aren't you lucky? I mean, I can't allow you to come in here and tell me what to do on my show.
Very well, Mr. Swell. Then, unfortunately, I shan't be able to appear on your show today.
Huh?
Or ever.
Oh.
Good day to you, sir.
Oh, now, wait. Hold on. Now, stop! No need to go off in a huff. Or even in a minute in a huff. Perhaps I was just a little bit too hasty, you know? Now, look. Why don't you show me how this V thing of yours works? Why don't you and the letter people make a word for me?
Sometimes you are very vexing, Mr. Swell. But very well. Any particular word?
Well, since you're so upset about your torn vest, why don't you and the letter people make the word vest?
Vest? A very good choice.
I thought so. Now, Mr. V, up there on our magic board is a picture of a vest. Let's make it.
We shall need some letter people. Myself, of course. Ms. E, Mr. S, and Mr. T.
Who goes in the starting clue box?
Vest. The starting sound I hear is my sound. The same sound that starts violet velvet vest. So I shall get in the starting clue box.
And I'll get in the catching clue box because the catching sound I hear is the same sound that starts exercise. My sound.
Vest. You're both right. Now we come to the ending clue box.
Vest. I hear my sound. The same sound that starts super socks. So I'll get in the ending clue box.
Well, there, I'm getting in the ending clue box because the ending sound I hear is the same sound that starts towel teeth.
You've got holes in your teeth. I clearly hear my super socks sound.
Yeah, and you've got starch in your socks. I hear my towel teeth sound.
Super socks.
Towel teeth.
Super socks.
Oh, listen, stop squabbling. Listen, since I'm the star of this show, I'll decide who goes in the ending clue box. Vest. Now, let's see. I believe Mr. S is right. He goes in the ending clue box.
Told ya!
All right, now, little people, let's prove to everyone that I am right, as usual. Make your sounds catch.
Yes.
Vess, yes, Vess. I told you I was, Vess, Vess. I think something's wrong.
I told you I was right. Come on, Mr. S, let me in that ending clue box, because the ending sound I hear is the same sound that starts Tall Teeth.
Grouch.
All right, enough, enough. Make your sounds catch.
Bet.
Bet. Better try it again.
Bet.
Something's still wrong. Now, you little people are cooperating.
May I make a suggestion, Monty?
Not now, Mr. V. I'm thinking. Let's see. Vest. Of course, I hear two sounds. First, Mr. S, and then Mr. T. But they're so very close together. So, Mr. S, you get back in the ending clue box, and Mr. T, you stand next to Mr. S outside the clue box. That'll work.
Monty, that won't work.
I can't make my sound unless I'm standing in a clue box.
Oh, that's right. Well, we'll just have to put you in the clue box, won't we then, Mr. T? Now, how we do that?
Look, Monty, it's really simple if you think about it. Since Mr. S and Mr. T must say their sounds close together, why not have them both get in the ending clue box?
I believe she is right, Monty. Mr. S and Mr. T are making their sounds blend together. Listen again. Best.
Well, as they say in the business, the show must go on. Mr. T, get on in the ending clue box with Mr. S.
This clue box isn't big enough for the two of us.
Oh, sure it is. Be a tight squeeze, but it'll have to do. Go on, Mr. T, get on in there.
Watch it. Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, isn't that cozy? Try it, letter people.
Best.
I hear it. Do it again.
Yes.
Oh, it works. Well, I knew it would. I mean, of course, I thought of it.
You're squishing my socks, Mr. T.
Yeah, and you're squishing my tall teeth.
I need air. I feel squished. Squish, squish, squish.
Squish?
Yeah, squish.
Sqoosh. What an excellent name.
Oh, do you think so, Miss E?
Whenever two or more letter boys have to be in the clue box together...
Because they must say their sounds very close together... Make them blend.
Yes, squoosh their sounds together. Why don't we call the clue box a squoosh box? Right now, Mr. S and Mr. T are in the ending squoosh box.
A very, very, very good idea, Ms. E. A squoosh box.
Yes, I like it myself. It has class. Don't you think we ought to do something with the clue box? Let everyone know that it's a squoosh box?
Oh, absolutely. Some kind of design.
Ziggity-zaggity edges, maybe?
A marvelous idea, Monty.
You mean I'm right for a change?
Ziggity-zaggity edges. Here, Monty, hold my barbell.
Ooh.
I think I know where I can get them. From Mr. Z.
Mr. H. Help!
Okay. You betcha, swell. Right after this message.
Pens. P-A-N.
Sqoosh box. Ending Sqoosh box.
Pens. P-A-N-S. Pens. Fans. F-A-N-S. Fans.
Oh, I love it. Ziggity-zaggity edges. But don't you have them on the wrong clue box, Mizzy? I mean, I thought we could only do an ending squoosh.
Sometimes the letter boys will have to squoosh their sounds at the start of a word, too. For instance...
Hey, Swellerino. You ready to try this gizmo again?
Excuse me, Mizzy. I got something I think you're really going to like. Two surprises in one show. The squoosh box, and now this. Okay, Mr. H, here goes. Stop the show. Buffo whammo. How's that for sparkle, Miss E, huh?
It'll really stop the show, Monty. It's yucky.
You're trying to tell me you don't like it? Oh, no. Okay, Mr. H, take it away.
No, wait. We'll use the stop sign to make a starting squoosh. We'll have the letter people make the word stop.
Stop!
The catching sound I hear is the same sound that starts obstinate. So Ms. O should be in the catching clue box. And the ending sound I hear is the same sound that starts pointy patches. So Mr. P should get in the ending clue box. Now in the starting clue box...
Starting squoosh box, Missy. I'm really on my toes today. For the starting squoosh box, first we need Mr. S, and then Mr. T.
Correct. They're squishing their sounds. The same sounds that start super socks and tall teeth. All right, we're ready. Try it, letter people.
Stop!
Don't stop now. We always do it twice.
Stop!
I heard the starting squoosh. Stop!
Stop!
Yes, stop! Please! You know, Missy, all this squishing gives me another idea.
Oh, no, not again.
Oh, but you're really gonna like this one, Missy. It's all about a starting squish.
Spin, spin. S, P, I, N. Spin. S, P, I, N. Spin. Spun. S-P-U-N. Spun. Spin. Spun. That's all.
You think that'll make a big splash? Get it? A big splash.
Yeah, that was real funny, Swell. Say, Missy has a surprise for you.
You're kidding. A surprise? You do? Oh, I love surprises. What is it, Missy?
I've written a song, and I thought we could all sing it.
Oh, a song? Is this it?
Yes, and it's all about squishing. Hit it, letter people. I think you'll love it, Monty.
Oh, I certainly hope so. Listen, you know, since I'm the star of this show, I'll sing the lead. Now here's a little something that we have learned to do. It's called the squish, and it's real fun, and you can learn it too. We'll squish our sounds together, make them almost one. Now just for you, an ending squish, listen how it's done.
Monty, I think I have some more.
Try fast and past and must and dust and best and zest and pans and fans and mint and hint and step and stop and snip and snap and spin and spun and snub and snob.
And snob, are you calling me a snob?
Oh, not,
what do you mean by calling me a snob?
Well, I don't
what do
mean,
mean
to call you a snob,
to
Monty, but you see, I'm squished out. I don't know what I'm saying.
Even though you did make some problems.